Hi everyone, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for tuning in with us. Before we get started, just wanted to say a quick thank you to everyone who's subscribed to the channel and liked our videos. If you enjoy what we're doing here, please consider liking and subscribing. It really helps us out. We really appreciate your time and thank you for watching. As part of our MO, let's get stuck into it. So today we're talking about Authelia. So what is Authelia? Authelia is an application used for authentication and authorization that you can lay on top of a web network or web addresses so that you can protect those endpoints using both two-factor authentication and some other methods as well. So it is an open source, full-featured authentication server. And it's available on GitHub. If you're a user of Unraid, I actually created the template that lives on the Unraid App Store. So if you come to the App Store and you type in Authelia, so this is my actual repository over here, and I published it out so people can use it. So this should make it a lot easier for you. I also wrote a lot of instructions on my own GitHub page here to get it working for everyone. So the purpose of today's video is we're basically going to go through this documentation, which I'll leave in the description below. And we're also going to be setting it up for use with NGINX Proxy Manager. So if you haven't used either before, this will be the video today showing you how to get that going. So let's scroll right up to the top and we'll leave that aside. I'll put it over to the other screen. Like I said, description, link will be in the description, so we can leave it there for you. So the first thing you're going to do is go to the App Store, or if you're using Docker, you know, follow the Docker instructions to get it down off their GitHub. And this is what you're going to see when you first start it up, or when you first go to install it. There's really not many parameters that need to be mapped. I've got the IP, the port set to 9091, the app data folder, as well as permission codes that go in there as well. But it's not set up yet. With Authelia, there is a little bit of configuration involved, and I'll show you what that looks like. So it's over here and it's ready, but let's say we just leave that for now. Reading the instructions we've got, there are some files that you'll need to modify to get working for you. You also need some dependencies installed and working as well. You can install Authelia without some of these dependencies. However, I strongly recommend that you follow this guide exactly as it's written out, because installing the light version of Authelia, it may suit you if you're at home, but later on, if you decide to scale it up for any reason, it's not going to be possible. So you might as well just start off with everything that you need. It also adds a little bit of redundancy to your setup, because if you lose Redis, for example, you lose your SQL database, for example, those things, you know, you're not going to worry about it too much later on down the track. You just have it set up and ready to go. So in the GitHub page, you'll find there are several files. The Authelia portal file is the configuration information that you'll need to put in the NGINX Proxy Manager. Same with this one here, but this will be on the endpoints that you want to protect. This is the configuration.yml for Authelia itself, which you need to have, and the user's database if you are not using LDAP. So you can use LDAP, but you can also use a user database file if you don't want to use LDAP. So we'll come down here, you can see where we're at, and we'll start with basically first step, Redis. So you need a Redis container. Again, not difficult to really do. I'll just move this over here. If you have Docker and you have Unraid, you have the App Store, you can just install Redis straight away. And that's it. Once you install it, it's pretty much running. So as for this, you can basically keep moving on. MySQL database. If you haven't installed MySQL before or MariaDB, same principle applies. Go to the App Store, click install, and then I've got the instructions right here explaining how to get the database up and running. So make sure you follow those instructions. You want to follow the code, and you need to replace anything with a placeholder. So in the top here in the references section, I explained that I've put placeholders in, so that makes it easier for you to find and replace them. So just make sure you replace those placeholders as you go along. I can't stress enough how confusing it can be if you're skipping steps, so make sure you just take your time and just follow the steps as we go along. So then we have Authelia. So once you've got these two sort of dependencies set up, we can start working on Authelia. Install the application in the app data folder that you have it in. It will create a configuration YML. If it does not, in the GitHub, we have that there as well. So don't stress, you can just use that there. There's no problem. So once you've got the configuration file, it's time to now set it up. So we'll just move that over to the side here. So once you first open it up, you don't really need to modify any of these settings. You've got your read, your write, and your path. Underneath, you'll have your JWT secrets. Now, there's a website here, argon2.online, which allows you to create secrets, allows you to create really high encryption passwords. And I recommend that for this because I've changed all the ones in here, but you'll need to make sure that they're secure and that they're private. And most of them you won't need to remember. These are used for just sessions, for example. Anything commented out, you can use. If you are using TOTP or you want to use that, the one-time pin, then you can uncomment it, as I've got here. I don't use Duo. You can use it. If you do, just make sure you uncomment it and edit all the information there as well. But that's not covered in my guide. An authentication backend. So with Authelia, you have two options. You can use a user file, which is in the GitHub repository as well, or you can use LDAP. Now, originally when I set up Authelia, I did use the user file. However, nowadays I actually use free IPA as an LDAP backend. I just think it's more secure and also think it's better to have a central sort of point where everything connects to. So this is what it looks like when you're setting up an LDAP. Again, it's all in the GitHub page. Scroll down a little bit further. So I'm just scrolling nice and slow in case you decide to pause the video, you can do that. These are the filters that I use when using free IPA. So just keep that in mind if you're using something else like Windows Active Directory, those filters will look different. A lot of these settings will probably look different. So let's keep going a little bit further. Here's the file backend. So if you're not going to use LDAP, you need to comment out all of the LDAP stuff and then uncomment from this point on for file backend. And here's the ACL, so or the access controls. So this is where you tell Authelia basically the default policy, I want you to deny everything. So if I don't know, if Authelia doesn't know who you are, deny. Then you can say, okay, for this particular address, I want you to allow anyone in the group admins, which is reading that from LDAP, mind you, or from your file, user file, put a one-factor policy on it. You can also supply two-factor, deny, or bypass. Come down a little further. You've then got your session. Session secrets, expiration, inactivity, how long to remember, for example, the domain that you want to protect, so make sure you fix that up. The details of your Redis container, so it's really important that you put your Redis information in there, which you can just get right from here, as you can see. Come down a little further. So this is more about the control of the users and what happens when they try too many times, for example. Your database information, so make sure you fill out what we followed, what you've set up in the above step with your database. This is where that would go. And you have some other settings there for SMTP and emails. You need to make sure that you get this working, because if you don't, it's not actually going to be able to send out any emails, which is not really going to help you. So I highly recommend that you set that up. Make sure you put your passwords, all that sort of stuff in there. Because if a user wants to reset their password, that's where they're going to get it from. Now, I know I'm just sort of skimming over this, but that's really all it is. The most time you're going to spend, I would say, is with the access controls, possibly the Duo, if you're setting up Duo, and LDAP if you're using LDAP. That's where most of your time will be spent, but the rest of it's pretty easy. Then you've got your NGINX Proxy Manager part of things. So once you've set up Authelia and you're happy with it, and you can tell that it's working, so let's start this up. So we've started up the container, and it's loaded correctly. We can tell it's loaded correctly because there's no errors or it hasn't stopped. You can also read the logs. And now we want to get it going. So if you were to go just to the web UI here, this is the local address. It's not really going to do anything because it's kind of not the point. So the next step you have to follow is to set up your NGINX Proxy Manager. So if we head to our proxy, and in my case, I have a DNS entry called identity.ibracorp. You can always go back to our last video with NGINX Proxy Manager to get a bit of a better understanding about DNS and using NGINX Proxy Manager. In here, you haven't got too much, but you do have a custom location, a custom NGINX config here. Now, this is available again on our GitHub at the top. So if we scroll to the top, you've got your configuration.yml. Authelia portal. Now it's explained in the instructions below, but Authelia portal is what goes in here. So you need to make sure you update that to your own details, if it's your own IP address and port, whatever you've set up. And then you can close that. So if we go to that now and just check that that works, excellent. We've typed in our username and password and we click sign in. We're authenticated. Now, if you wanted to protect an endpoint by using that, this is what you would put in to there. So let's copy this for example. So let's copy this for example, and we'll come back to NGINX Proxy Manager. So let's say we're ready to protect an endpoint now. And in this case, we're going to protect our status page. In NGINX Proxy Manager, we'll go to Edit, Advanced. And we will copy the endpoint conf information from the GitHub page. Scroll to the top and we'll just make sure we read it to make sure everything is correct. So the server address is correct, the port, that looks correct. Scroll down a little further. We need to change the container name here. And in this case, for us, it's actually Kshit. So we'll change that to Kshit. Go down a little further. We're going to make sure our URL is correct for Authelia. And remember, these have placeholders in them, so you'll be able to see them in capitals. Just make sure that you change them. Then we hit on status, and we are forbidden. So you may be wondering why we're getting a 403 forbidden. The reason why is because earlier we said the default policy is to deny. Okay. As you can see in the rules, we don't have an explicit setting for this domain. So what we're going to do is set one up for it. So the safest bet is to always just copy it from above. Try and remove any spaces. And in here, we'll say status.ibracorp.io. I want the same users to be able to access it, so that's fine. And also want one-factor authentication, so that's fine as well. We'll hit save. Then you need to make sure you come back and restart your Authelia container so that the new settings take effect. So we'll just restart that. Give it a second. There you go. Now, if we go to incognito, just to make sure, it's always a good idea to go to incognito just to double check. So this is what the workflow will now look like. So we've hit the authentication portal, and now it's asking us to log in. We've said that it's a protected endpoint, so that's fine. Hit sign in. It will then redirect you to the original site that you enter and we're authenticated. Now here's some other extra little feature that you might not know about Authelia that I really like. If you go to the portal address that you've set up, you can see that we're logged in. Now, because I'm an administrator, my name won't come up, but you can set it to actually show the name. Log out. And you can stay on this actual portal. Now, it will actually allow you to reset a password right here, even if it's an LDAP password, which is quite cool. So if you didn't want to use a different solution, you could use that. In our case, we actually have set up PWM as our portal solution to manage identity, but you can use that as well. So you just follow the same rule and apply that to other domains, and you can have a protected setup any way you like. So that's Authelia for you. I hope that was a quick explanation. Because I've already written the instructions, I didn't want to sort of repeat myself, but to help people see it visually, I think is really important. And I know that when I was setting it up, it took me approximately 2 months to get this working because there was just such little documentation in terms of setting it up with Unraid that I had to learn it myself. So I just wanted to share that with everyone to save you the time that it took me. So I hope that was helpful. And if you need more information, please let me know. If you want to know more, just ask in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps a lot. Thank you very much.